What do a truck driver, a risk manager, a real estate agent, and a trained weather spotter have in common? They are all local photographers who capture the beauty of Arizona. News 4 Tucson's Stephanie Weaver has the story you'll see only on 4.
One of my favorite parts as a weather anchor is to put our viewers' photos on our newscasts. But some photographers just stick out over and over again. But who are the photographers behind these photos? That's what I wanted to find out. Here in Arizona, you may not know them by name, but you know them by their photographs. Capturing the essence of what Tucsonans call the Old Pueblo. Cacti commanding the desert landscapes, sunrises and sunsets exploding with color, and monsoon storms that can strike with intense force. And these local photographers each have a unique story with a different process in capturing the spirit of the Southwest. Scott Kimball is a professional truck driver. Whether he is rising early or burning the midnight oil, it's the long hours and the long drives that enable him to capture amazing shots.
There's so much to see out there, and at 6,000 miles a week on average, I haven't even scratched the surface of what there is to see in this amazing world. I see more things in one day than the average person sees in a lifetime.
And these photographers quickly learn the meaning of the word viral, like Greg McCown. He's a real estate agent and native to Tucson. And it was his iconic shot that captured the attention of many.
USA Today called, Washington Post, US Post, Huffington Post, all the posts called. NBC Nightly News shared it on their television segment, and so did the Today Show.
Or one of Kimball's photographs, which hangs in the White House.
It blew my mind. At that point, I knew I had succeeded in my dream and my goal, and I finally knew I had made it.
But there is a risk. Lori Bailey is a trained weather spotter for the National Weather Service.
The more you chase, the more obsessed you get. It's grueling. There's painstaking hours that go into it, but to be able to capture that one shot, you know it was so worth it.
While she says it's a bit of an obsession, safety is first.
You have to ask yourself, when is it too close? And learning to do this over time, you get a feel for how close is too close.
And if you want a striking shot of your own,
turn your camera to manual. That little M button scares people to death. But if you switch it over to manual and you just start playing with the camera, I would say shoot that way for at least a month and be taking pictures every day.
And for Justin Northcraft, it's even more. It was in 2006 that his father passed away, and just 2 months later, Justin was in the hospital for a ruptured AVM. Justin realized he wanted to spend more time with his family doing the things that he loved. And that's when photography came in.
We chase sunsets, we chase monsoon storms, and we love to chase the night sky as well. And Tucson is a perfect place for that.
But the reason these photographers wait for the perfect storm or sunset?
Your problems, your stresses, just go by the wayside when you're sitting there in the splendor of a beautiful Arizona sky.
It's a joy and a peacefulness. It's excitement. It's all rolled up into one.
For me, it's an adrenaline rush. The second I hear thunder or lightning, I might as well get up because I'm not going back to sleep.
Memories. Really, it's memories. Because I'm out creating those memories with my boys when we do these things. They're moments that they're never going to forget.
I'm Stephanie Weaver, News 4 Tucson.
What a cool story, and there is more News 4 Tucson right after the break.